Welcome to the second in a series of short videos that I'm sharing with some tips on church leadership and management. These tips come from our Management for Church Leaders training, which we have been teaching globally for over 20 years. In this video, the second tip I want to share is that leadership and authority are not the same thing. We read from Scripture from John chapter 10, verses 2 through 4. The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of his sheep. The watchman opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. In this scripture passage, we learn that we must know the people we lead as Jesus knew his disciples. Leaders must know their followers' spiritual gifts. God has given every individual spiritual gifts to be used in ministry. So it's important for a leader to know those spiritual gifts so they can help people find their role in ministry. Secondly, leaders must know their level of faith. They must know their strengths and weaknesses and what they need to grow as a disciple of Jesus Christ. And third, leaders must have their followers trust and respect, because people aren't going to follow you unless they trust you or respect you. Leadership is really about influence. John Maxwell says that leadership is influence, nothing more and nothing less. Influence is your ability to motivate others to action. So it's about encouragement. It's about getting people to do things for the ministry that are important. You earn your influence by building up trust and respect. Again, people will follow you if they trust you and they respect you. And influence is about getting people to willingly follow your direction. It's not about compulsion. They want to follow you because they trust and respect you, and they know that you have their best interest at heart. On the other hand, authority is really about power. The dictionary describes authority as the power to command or control opinion, thought, or behavior. So power is derived actually from your position or your title. If you are the pastor of a church, you have certain responsibilities and things that you're accountable for. If you're the president of a ministry or of a congregation, you have certain authorities that you can implement. That's your power. But power is also about control. It's about your ability to get people to do things they may not want to do. So authority is the power to enforce your decisions on others. So you have to be careful when you use your authority, because you're really forcing people to do things rather than them being willing to follow your directions. And finally, leaders should use their influence, not their power. With influence, people want to follow you. They come along willingly and you don't have any problems. But if you have to use your power and your authority, you are forcing people to follow you, and therefore you may be creating opposition. People that don't like the direction you're taking them, and that could become a problem in your ministry in the days to come. Thank you for watching this video. I hope that this was of value to you. Next time, I'll be discussing the need for pastors and leaders to have a vision for their church or ministry. To request a free copy of our Management for Church Leaders self-training book or any of our other training resources, please visit our website at www.faithlifeministries.net.